We will solve HC verma problem 72, chapter 29. In this, we are given an arrangement like this. There is an equilateral triangle. Twice Q charge is here, minus Q is here, minus Q is here, and these distances are d. We have to find the resultant dipole moment for this. So in this problem, separate this Q into two parts as if there are two Q's. The result is same. Now by doing this, you immediately get a hint that this is one dipole and this is another dipole. And dipole moment is a vector quantity. It has a direction. What is the dipole moment of this? These two, that is minus Q here and plus Q here, will have a dipole moment equal to charge times the distance, which is Q D, and dipole moment is always from the negative charge to the positive charge. This is the direction. Now here there is another dipole moment, minus Q plus Q. So this is another dipole moment. This is also equal to QD. So you have two dipole moments. Let me write this as P1 and P2. Both magnitude are same and they are along the sides of this equilateral triangle. So by symmetry, and these are equal in magnitude, so you can straight away take their projection along the bisector of this triangle. This will be 30 degrees, this will be 30 degrees. That is, here you can show it. This is 30, this is 30. So this will be P1 cos 30, and because of this again P2 cos 30. P1 and P2 are same, we can write P. So it is P cos 30 plus P cos 30. These are the two dipole moments. What is the value of cos 30? 30 cos 30 is nothing but root 3 upon 2. So this will be root 3 upon 2 into P plus root 3 upon 2 into P, which means root 3P. And what is the value of P is QD. So it is root 3 QD is the answer. We could have also done, without taking the projection, we could have done using the vector form. This is one, this is another, and this is QD, this is QD. Angle between them is 30 degree. You could have solved using the vector method also. But in such cases, it is more easier when you have two equal vectors and they are making certain angle between them. There are two equal vectors in terms of the magnitude. Always take their bisector and take their half angle projection. Add them straight away and you get the answer. Thank you.